only sport and a lonely business, and you know, it's oftentimes hard to know who to trust. Trust is a hard thing in boxing to find. If you find somebody you can trust and you can get along with, you're a very lucky man.
It's a statement Fitzroy Vanderpool is highly qualified to make. He's traveling a unique road to success as a pro boxer, going it alone virtually every step of the way.
I've said before, I even won my first title, that if I have to do it all myself, I will do it, because I will be world champ. Nothing will stop me.
He has yet to wrap his hands around that coveted world championship belt, but three titles later, that promise is turning out to be a self-fulfilling prophecy.
About 3 years ago, I won the Canadian welterweight championship, and from there I went on to win, on April 22nd of this year in Toronto, I won the World Boxing Federation Intercontinental title. And recently, on November the 2nd, I went on to win the World Boxing Council Fekkerbox title, which has given me a top 15 world ranking. And I was voted Canadian Boxer of the Year 1997-98.
The trick now is to step out of the shadows and into the ring with one of boxing's heavy hitters.
You're talking about Oscar De La Hoya. He's actually the big one. Then there's Felix Trinidad, and there's James Page, who recently won the welterweight title. So those are the big three.
The 31-year-old Kitchener native turned pro at 25. And for the most part, he's been self-managed, self-promoted, and self-financed. And it's been a struggle, but he remains self-determined.
It's tough because I'm not always 100% in the ring. I'm always thinking about, you know, where the next meal is coming from, or, you know, paying the bills, that kind of thing. So I'm not 100% as far as a lot of these other fighters at this world-class level. These guys are always in the gym training 100%. Myself, I'm not. But, you know, like I've said before, Trev, you know, the bottom line is, if I have to do it myself to be a world champ, I will. I'll get there.
Our guest is the WBF, the WBC Intercontinental Champion, and the Canadian welterweight title holder, Fitzroy the Whip Vanderpool. Every boxer has a good nickname, and you are no exception. You are the Whip. Oh, and he brought a whip.
Oh, yeah.
How'd you get that?
The Whip actually stands for, with hope, it's possible. With hope, it's possible.
You're into that positive thinking mode, man. That's great.
Have to be. Patience and persistence. I've been doing it on my own, and I just got to keep striving.
Good point, Fitzroy. Okay, who are you going to give the money to?
I'm going to give the money to Rights for Fathers and Children. It's an organization that myself and I'm getting some help from Rick Belfay from Unique Screen Printing and Embroidery in Waterloo. We're starting up an organization to help fathers and children.
Okay. And a little bit earlier in the show, you might have heard Fitz's cheering section in the background. It was this young man. He's a good lad.
Our final finalist comes from boxing. Fitzroy Vanderpool, or Fitz the Whip. He is the World Boxing Federation's Intercontinental Welterweight Champion. Vanderpool is also the Boxer of the Year by the Canadian Professional Boxing Federation. A rarity in professional boxing in that the Whip is self-managed. Vanderpool successfully defended his title last April against challenger Ron Pasek by unanimous decision. Outside the ring, Vanderpool spends his time as a fire prevention ambassador of North America. He accepted that role as put forward by the Kitchener Fire Department. It involves lending his voice and image to a series of fire safety public service announcements. Fitz also works with troubled youth and works in sales.
1999 Civitan Sports Waterloo Region Athlete of the Year is Fitzroy Vanderpool.
From the first time the doctor placed you in my arms, I knew I'd meet death before I let you meet harm. Although questions arose in my mind, would I be man enough? Against wrong, choose right and be standing up. From the hospital that first night, took an hour just to get the car seat in right. People driving off fast got me kind of upset. Got you home safe, placed you in your bassinet. That night, I don't think one wink I slept. As I slipped out my bed to your crib, I crept. Touched your head gently, felt my heart melt. Cause I knew I loved you more than life itself. Into my knees, and I begged the Lord, please, let me be a good daddy, all he needs.